So recently, I was trying to document every movie drive-in theater critic Joe Bob Briggs has ever talked about. The reasons why aren't important. If I explained them to you, it still wouldn't make sense. Just trust this was something I was doing. Well, pretty good record exists of the movies he's talked about on his shows, but not so much his written work. But I was fortunate enough to finally stumble upon an archive from the Dallas Observer. So I begin the arduous process of going through every review and finding out what movie it's a review of. Something easier said than done, because none of these reviews are titled, and Joe Bob spends the first half of the review talking about complete nonsense, almost always something sexist. He doesn't start talking about the movie until about halfway through the review. So great, I'm doing this, and I find this one dated July 13th, 1995. A review of the film Girlquake, which he describes as a tribute to the legendary Russ Meyer from director Michael Randall. Problem: I couldn't find any evidence this movie existed. Like, I googled Girlquake, Girlquake 1995, Girlquake movie, couldn't find anything. Went to IMDb, no Girlquake on IMDb. Looked up Michael Randall, no Michael Randall that could possibly have been directing this movie on IMDb. I was legitimately beginning to think Joe Bob Briggs made up a movie. I did finally find some evidence this movie existed by googling Girlquake Michael Randall. I found the resume of Mick Cribben, the director of the trauma classic Beware Children at Play, cinematographer for a lot of little low-budget movies, and on his resume he lists that he worked on Girlquake, directed by Michael Randall. And I even found Michael Randall's janky HTML website, which has a few references to Girlquake. He has a link to Joe Bob's review, as well as a link to the websites of some of the other actors that appeared in the film, one of whom actually cites Girlquake as being something they appeared in. So great, I got some resumes that say they worked on Girlquake. Is there any evidence it was released? I found it in two books, and it's the weirdest books. One of them is a diet book called For Women Only, Your Guide to Health Empowerment, by Gary Null and Barbara Seaman, which opens with a description of the film's opening scene, directly calling it Girlquake and citing Michael Randall as the director. The other is a book called Up Is Up, But So Is Down, New York's Downtown Literary Scene. It describes Michael Randall as a guitar player, a painter, and a poet, and mentions that he wrote and directed the semi-legendary B-movie Girlquake. So semi-legendary that 25 years later, I had difficulty proving it existed. So now I'm convinced Girlquake was real. It existed. There's too many sources here saying it does exist for me to not believe in it. But that's about where my search ended. I know it exists, but I couldn't find anything attached to it. No posters, no stills, and certainly not the movie itself. So what the fuck happened to this movie? Well, every source calls it an indie movie or a B-movie, so chances are it was made for very little money, released to very few theaters, never picked up a major distributor, and thus never got a home media release, and just sort of fell through the cracks since 1995. Weirdly though, every source that discussed it seemed to have pretty positive things to say about the film, so it's weird that something so good just sort of disappeared. And so, submitted for the approval of the Lost Media Council, Michael Randall's Girlquake. Where is it? What happened to it? Can we find anything else attached to it? I'm interested to see where this goes, you know. Most lost movies people talk about tend to be from, like, the way early days of film, when film preservation was really bad. So finding out something got lost from the year I was born is kind of weird. Anyways, until next time, have a great day.